still lied. Whoa, yeah.
Take off the foo-foo. Take off the cloud chase. Take off the Wi-Fi. Take off the money phone. Take off the car loan. Take off the flex and the white loss. Take off the weird jewelry. I'ma take 10 steps, then I'm taking off top off. Take off some fabricated dreams and the microwave memes. It's a real world outside. Take off your idols. Take off the runway. Take off the Cairo. Take off the Sandro pay. 5 days stay. Take a quarter meal. Hella final. Take off the far flat. Take off perception. Take off the cop with the iPad. Take off the allure. Take off the unsure. Take off decisions I lack. Take off the fake deep. Take off the fake woke. Take off the I'm broke. I care. Take off the gossip. Take off the new logic. That if I'm rich, I'm real. Take off the shirt nail. Take off the Doge. Take off the Birkin bag. Take all that designer off. And what do you have?
You ugly.
You out of pocket.
Two ATMs. You stepping to what?
You out of pocket.
Who you think they talk about? Talk about us.
You out of pocket.
Who you think they carry up? Carry up us.
The world in a panic, the women is stranded, the men on the run. The profits are banished, the laws take advantage. The market is crashing, the industry wants to sleep in the box while they making a mockery following us. This ain't monopoly, watch it for love. This ain't monogamy, y'all getting bogged. Jumping on what the hell is that? I gotta relax when I feel. All my descendants, they come in my sleep and say I am too real. I'm done with the sensitive, taking it personal. Done with the black and the white, the wrong and the right. You hoping for change and miracles. I know the feelings that came with burials, cries.
You ugly.
You out of pocket.
Two ATMs. You stepping to what?
You out of pocket.
Who you think they talk about? Talk about us.
You out of pocket.
Who you think they carry up? Carry up us.
Serving up a look, dancing in a drop. Hello to the big step, but never lose account. Venting in the safe house. Venting in the safe.
Can I fit on my truth? I got nothing to lose. I got problems and pools. I can swim in my fate. Cameras moving, whenever I'm moving. The family suing, whatever I make. Murder is stacking. The president acting. The government taxing. My funds in the bank. Homies ejecting. The fence when I'm breaking. Look at my reaction. My pupils on skates. Hold up, hold up.
Let's think about this for a second. Tell me what you would do for steady. When you show your show, don't crack. When you show your bro for leverage.
What a hypocrite said. What community feel they the only ones relevant? What a hypocrite said. What community feel they the only ones relevant?
You out of pocket, dude. You out of pocket. You entertain the mediocre, need to stop it. You entertaining old friends when they toxic. What your life like? The gossip.
What the fuck is council culture, dog? Say what I want about you, but you. I'm like overdog. I treat you like I'm Jigga. Watch, I own it all. Oh, you worry about a critic? That ain't protocol.
Okay, say no more. Tell the chauffeur to open Mercedes door. Put the pedal to metal and made it soar. She was, but I made it sure it was. So we stayed indoors. Let's take it where no one has been before. It feel like I've known you some years before, but I don't know.
Are you ready? Okay, say no more. Are you ready? Okay, say no more.
She's a lotus and I'm the conductor of a magnum opus. Simply braggadocious. Why don't we take advantage of this moment? And wherever you are.
These players are on the last year of their contract. Re-sign them to avoid losing them next season.
Nobody really cares.
Mama, I'm on the big screen. I took a big swing out of life. I'm doing big things in my life. I deserve 6 rings like a Mike. I got a no sleep. I remember when it was the nosebleeds. Now they captured the fashion from flow seats. I'm a whole king.
Are you ready? Okay, say no more. Are you ready? Okay, say no more.
She's a lotus and I'm the conductor of a magnum opus. Simply braggadocious. Why don't we take advantage of this moment? And wherever you own, we own it.
Ooh, it's trouble in paradise. So let's parachute where the air's nice. And let's risk it all on the paradise. But she just wanna make sure her hair's nice. That's fair, right? I just fell in love with a prima donna. The 2023 Madonna. I mean, your honor. I was minding my business until she gave me complete nirvana.
Are you ready? Okay, say no more. Are you ready? Okay, say no more.
She's a lotus and I'm the conductor of a magnet.
got your best friend hanging out the arm though.
Yeah.
Got game like I'm dropping me a console. No, I don't swim, but I give a now flex. While you dare look in the press, feel the get up in your chest. While I soak up my success, getting tokens for your stress. I'll be making all the checks anytime you see me step on a stage. Acting real suck like my skin coming beige. Gonna step out and with him, girl, you fake. Try to get it out, what you handsome? You ain't dance on. Tell your boyfriend, go and put your pants on.
Damn.
The best friend, she went and did the same thing. I'm really mad, but she won't know. Everything has gotta be cool when we living so cold. Feel it in your bones. You ain't gonna feel it till I'm gone. Caught up in your feelings, now you froze. And everything around you getting cold. The chill is in my.
Welcome to week one of the NFL preseason, where the rookies of today hope to become the stars of tomorrow. It's the Packers and the Chargers under the lights on Sunday night.
Night beginning to fall over Southern California, but the lights are shining bright here at the spectacular SoFi Stadium in metropolitan Los Angeles. Tonight, we kick off the preseason with a good matchup right away between the Green Bay Packers and the Los Angeles Chargers. Charles Davis alongside me, and I'm Brandon Gaudin. And folks, the wait is over. Yes, it's just the preseason, but football is back in your living room.
And I'm excited. I know you are as well. The summer heat feels good on these old bones, especially because we're not putting on pads. We don't have to be out there in that heat running into other people. But I'm glad these guys are. Football is back.
The former Auburn kicker Daniel Carlson to get this one started, and off we go to wrap up this Sunday of action. And the opening kickoff will not be returned, as that will be a touchback. Here are the Chargers ready to go on offense, led by their first round pick in 2020, the man out of Oregon, Justin Herbert.
It hasn't taken Herbert long to earn the status as one of the league's best and most entertaining passers. He's locked and loaded on every snap, and the second he sees an opening, the ball soaring downfield. You've got to be on your A game at all times against him. The second you slip up, he's liable to burn you.
They'll start out here with a jet sweep. And that is the kind of tackling they want to see all game, as he'll lose yardage to start things out. It'll go as a loss of a yard on the game's first play. Second down.
As a wideout, when you take that handoff and you're coming around the edge, you're expecting to see nothing but empty space in front of you. But if not...
Well, things can go south in a hurry, and that's exactly what we saw in that play with a loss. The loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. Here's the first carry for Austin Ekeler. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30. Third play here this opening drive as they're up against a 3rd and 5. Now Herbert with it, looking to pass. He'll get this out wide to Ekeler. And they're going to get him down well short of the first, as he can only get this to the 30. They'll get only a yard out of that, and it'll bring up 4th down.
Well, able to get the completion, but unfortunately not able to get the 3rd down conversion there on that play.
And I like how the defense approached that one. They knew where the 1st down marker was, and they decide whatever you want to have, you can. You're just not going to get the 1st down. Excellent tackling right there.
On 4th down, Don Maggio out to punt. This is fielded at the 27. A nice run back there off the good punt. It's a 16-yard return.
And it'll be Packer football here. First down and 10. Time to see the offense for Green Bay go to work. Aaron Rodgers leading them. What a career it's been. Came into the league back in 2005 as the number 24 pick out of Cal.
There have been very few quarterbacks in the NFL who have been as consistent throughout their career as Aaron Rodgers. He's been good for so long, and we've seen no decline in his skills. His accuracy and arm strength continue to elevate the talent around him, and his in-game mistakes, few and far between.
Now the man from UTEP, this is Aaron Jones. He'll get this up to the 47 and brought down there.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. Wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
Following the pickup of four, here's second and six. They'll go again to Jones. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. 7 yards there and a first down.
And that's a nice pickup of a first down on that second down run. And at that yardage gained, they can run that play on any down.
This one swung out here to Jones. And he's going to be taken down just shy of the 35.
And a nice gain and a broken tackle along the way. And really, we shouldn't be surprised, should we? That's what runners do, especially the best ones. They break tackles and gain extra yardage.
Shoves him away. And he'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. 17 yards on the play there as the Packers have the first down as well. You were telling me this yesterday. That's exactly what they want to do on the opening drive, establish the ground game.
Yeah, remember our conversation. We were talking about what one of the GMs in the league has told me repeatedly. It's a big man's game, and it's not necessarily size. He's talking about playing some big boy football. Line up, get leverage, knock people back, and establish the run early.
After the run by Jones, here's first and 10. Into the red zone, it's Rodgers. A check down here to Jones. And out of bounds all the way down at the 3. Another strong gain on the last two plays. They moved it a combined 33 yards. Aaron Jones, you know, not one of the bigger backs in the league, 5'9", 208, but he's definitely what you'd call a downhill runner. And he's able to shed the tacklers there for good yardage.
And as a former defender, I can tell you with certainty, those are the ones that have you losing sleep at night. I would not like to be in that film room on Tuesday going over that one. Just a pretty poor effort defensively, and it leads to a big play.
And the next-gen stats shows us the tale of how much yardage he was able to pick up after the initial contact. First and goal from the 3. Jones, going to be stopped before he can get moving forward as he'll lose a couple back to the 5-yard line. They'll try again with Jones. And now he's out there. He gets to the couple, taking it for the 5 down to the 3. This Charger defense continuing to hold the line. Now it's a 3rd and goal situation. They'll try and run it in with Jones. And this time he is in. Aaron Jones with career touchdown number 125, moving him into a tie with Walter Payton on the all-time list.
And the Packers will claim the early lead as they're on the board first here tonight. Thank you.
Now for the extra point, Daniel Carlson. And it's good to make it 7-0 Packers. So that drive in total, 8 plays. And the last play in the drive was a touchdown run by Aaron Jones.
Daniel Carlson is set to kick it.
Following the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Carlson. And this will be a touchback, so they'll bring it out to the 25. The Chargers get set to go here for their second drive. And on the first drive, 3 and out. And I know that these are professional athletes, but I would imagine sometimes you get the nerves at the beginning of a game still, don't you?
Those don't ever go away. And typically, what I've heard from guys and what I remember from playing, if you don't have nerves at the start of a game, it's not going to be a great day for you. You're not really ready to play. So finding a way to harness those nerves and not let them affect you in a negative way, that's what all the guys are looking for.
Throwing again on 2nd and 10. Herbert. And this is caught. First catch for Keenan Allen. And they work this well upfield across the 45. 22 yards there. A first down. The play fake, and now Herbert to throw. Blitz coming, and down he goes. Multiple players combined for their team's first sack of the game. A CD, you know, so often we talk about quarterbacks holding on to the ball too long. Well, we can't say that there. He had no time to do much of anything.
And this came from the edge, and those pass rushers, they have so many tricks of the trade to get around blockers. They have a lot of tools in their kit. This was pure speed and athleticism on this play, though. Nick could barely get a glove on him before he got the quarterback on the ground.
They'll run under pressure again, and down he goes again. Rashawn Gary that time fighting free and getting to the quarterback. Man, he got in there so quickly, Charles. What could the offense have done to adjust and account for that?
But what you're hoping is that you figure out and you see and get a clue that maybe there's going to be some pressure coming at you, and you change the blocking schemes. Maybe you go to max protection. The biggest ones, maybe bring your running back in to try and keep you clean. But in that case, that didn't happen. Zero accountability, and a sack resulted.
Charger football to start quarter number two, as they've got it with a 3rd down and long coming up. Boy, a tough spot here as they approach the line of scrimmage. A long way to go to try to pick up this first down. Now a 3rd down throw, but it misses the target, incomplete.
Every offense tells you they want to come out and start fast. That's not unusual at all. But this group, they've yet to get much rolling through their first 2 drives. It looks like they're going to have to give up the football again after this one.
So they're forced to punt on 4th as this one's away. Fielded just inside the 30. They'll score that a 36-yard punt, and they will take over 1st and 10. The Packers offense here coming back out for their second drive. They'll be looking to duplicate that first drive, the one that got them that 7-0 lead.
Of course they would. I mean, look, they're on the road. So getting the 7-0 lead was huge for them, right? Imagine getting up 2 touchdowns on the road, taking the crowd out of the game. It would be ideal.
And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. Solid way to start the drive, 13 yards, picking up the first.
So many times in my career, I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing, but as long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
Dylan now on 1st and 10. And he's going to get across midfield and into Charger territory. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on 2nd and short. Again, it's Dylan. Uses the stiff arm. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. 7 yards there and a 1st down.
2nd and 2 is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a 1st down, keep the sticks moving.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. From the gun, it's Dillon. And he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. So after the loss of a yard, they'll look to push forward here on second down and 11. Now to the air, Block. He'll dump this down to Dillon, that's complete. And he'll be taken down here just shy of the 30.
You see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
Try and run for the first with Dillon. And he'll go down here right around the 23-yard line. 8 yards on the pick up there, and he moves the sticks.
And that's the big fella's MO right there. Running through tackles, keeping the sticks moving forward. And this defense, if you don't bring 11 guys to the ball to try and get him on the ground, he's going to keep making runs like that. I feel the press box shaking every time he touches the rock.
Jet sweep, Dobbs. He is taken down at the 21 after a short gain of 2. Throwing on 2nd and 8, Block. And that'll be incomplete.
But it certainly did a nice job there, picking him up out of the backfield and then running stride for stride with it. That's good coverage, and it led to an incompletion.
Here's Lock to throw, sliding out of the pocket. And he will get this into the end zone. Touchdown, Green Bay. Drew Lock, a 21-yard touchdown run. And the Packers have taken a 2-touchdown lead now. Another impressive drive. So they're 2 for 2, 2 touchdowns. Charles, a great start to this ball game for them.
And one of the words that's really worked its way into our lexicon is stacking. They've stacked momentum each time out, and not only on offense. Between those touchdowns, defense held, forced a punt to get the ball back, and they've played awfully well in this one. Both sides playing at optimum level.
Carlson now to add the extra point. And it's good to make it 14-0. A good drive that time as they go 9 plays in all. And the last play, a really nice run that culminated in the touchdown. Following the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Carlson. No run back here for Reed, so this will come out to the 25. And the Chargers coming out of the field now. Still in the first half, but this offense has struggled. Haven't really been able to get anything going, not only in the points category, but in the yards category. We'll see if they can do better here on this drive. A handoff to Spiller to begin the drive. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here. And if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
Blau. And the Packers give him nowhere to go, and they bring him down.
Holding offense.
So they will take the sack instead of the penalty.
And it takes another down off the series. But the biggest one of all, do you want to tell the guy who just got the sack that it no longer counts?
No.
No, not at all.
On 3rd down, Kelly. call it a gain of four, but not enough. The punt team going to need to be summoned here on fourth down.
Well, they got off the field on third down. Excellent job, an excellent defensive series. We always talk about adjustments, and usually only at halftime. But the best teams adjust series to series. And on that series, they adjusted so well that they got the job done in fine style.
Here's DiMaggio now. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. Fielded at about the 28. It'll be a net of only 30 here. 40-yard punt, 10 on the return.
And it will be first and 10 as they take over.
The Packers offense now, they get ready to head back on the field.
It has been about as perfect of a start to this game as these guys could have asked for, Charles. They've scored on their first two drives. They still haven't given anything up on the other side of the ball. So they can already make this a three-score game here if they can come away with points on this drive.
Yeah, they're almost pushing to the brink, aren't they, partner? Almost to the point now where it's a loss of words for me, which I know would excite all my viewers. But you're just now supposed to see that type of dominance so quickly in a game like this. Everything they've done has been working so far. Offense, defense, you name it, it's going well for them.
Well, fans of old school football, they got to be loving this, partner. All three drives so far have ended in a touchdown and all three on the ground.
And when you say fans of old school football, count me in, because you just don't see ground games dominate the scoring by pounding the rock like this anymore. To me, this is refreshing.
Carlson on for the PAT. And it is now 21 to nothing. So they hit pay dirt on just one play. The long run, the scamper, and a very nice scamper into the end zone for the touchdown.
Daniel Carlson is set to kick off.
Following the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Carlson.
And this will come out to the 25 as Reed opts for the touchback. The Chargers going to take over now late in this first half. But Charles, you're down multiple scores, less than a minute left here. But with that deficit, they've got to try to at least work their way into field goal range to try to muster something out of this drive.
And I'm going to go ahead and date myself one more time because I'm going to quote an old Smokey and the Bandit lyric. They've got a long way to go and a short time to get there, but they still have time to get it done. So I'm looking forward to watching them mount this drive and see if they can get some points out of it.
Throwing on first down, but this one lines up to be incomplete. So the incompletion, and now it's second and 10 again from the 25-yard line. Here's Blau to throw. And on the left sideline, he caught it, but out of bounds, according to the head linesman. Incomplete, so the ball a little late getting there, and it's third down. Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. On third down, it's Spiller. And this will not get close to the first down marker as he's brought down at the 26. Just a one-yard gain on the play, and that'll mean a call to the punt team as it's fourth down.
We often talk of situational football. Let's just call it team football. The defense did their job, got off the field, brought the punting situation, so they're turning the ball back over to their offense. You think those guys will get along very well right now? Of course they will. Defense helped the offense. Now it's their turn to take it downfield.
On fourth down, the punt team is on as this is sent away. That's pulled in at the 32. Call that a punt of 38 yards officially. And there'll be time for maybe one final play before halftime.
Let's go now.
The drive starts with a carry by Dillon. And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up. So we have reached halftime in our first preseason matchup of the year. As we send you to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach?
Okay, Brandon, thank you very much. Back to you guys in just a minute as we've started the countdown to opening night. Remember, the preseason has shrunk from four games down to three. So just two more weeks of preseason action follow this, and then we get it all started on the first Thursday after Labor Day. But meanwhile, for the Chargers, the rushing numbers tell a different story. They really couldn't get a whole lot going on the ground. And the evidence? the numbers. Most of the starters are likely done. These coaching staffs getting ready to evaluate the youngsters in the second half. And to call the remainder of this preseason opener, we go back to Brandon God.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. Probably not likely to see many starters in the second half as we get back at it underway in this preseason opener. This fielded right at the goal line. Oh, a good return up past the 30. There he goes, left side, past the 20. And he will score. Touchdown. Such an electric play, so much fun to watch, and you need all 11 guys in sync for that to be successful, don't you?
Without a doubt. That's teamwork, to be able to put it all together. But that play is really probably the most exciting 10 seconds in football.
Carlson now to add the extra point. It's good, and they stretch their lead to 28-0 now. And what a job there by all 11 on the kick return. The blocking excellent, the return excellent. The result, 6 points. So let's try this again. After the kick return TD, here's yet another kickoff. And we will not see an attempt to match that return touchdown, as this will be a touchback and bring it out to the 25. Now we'll look at the Chargers offense. They get ready for their first possession of the second half.
A CD, they certainly know the hole that they face as they begin the second half. They have to do what precious few teams have done in NFL history. That's try to come back from a 4-possession deficit.
And partner, you know, as that team gathers, they're saying to each other, you never say never, right? Because if you're on an NFL roster, that's how you have to think. You can always come back and win a ball game. And let's face it, we saw a certain Super Bowl, a 25-point lead late that wasn't enough to put someone away. But that being said, this task is near impossible. Let's face it. And bottom line is, it officially becomes impossible if this possession is an empty one.
And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Throwing is Blau. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. Well, hang on now, we're going to pause here. We've got an injured player. More from L.A. in a moment. Second down, here's Blau. And this is incomplete.
Intended for Trey McKinney. Incomplete. Brings up third down and 3 yards.
These guys have punted 4 times already, and they're staring at a 5th, barring a conversion here on third down. Blau setting up to throw. Packer pressure, and down he goes. He could not get away that time, and it'll be a loss of 11 on third down.
It's been a tough one all game long for this offensive line. They're already down big, and now you know they're just going to come after the quarterback in a big way, don't you?
Yeah, they just can't get out of their own way right now. It's created an avalanche, and an avalanche is coming right on top of them.
On is the Chargers punter now, as he'll come on for his 5th kick of the night. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. This is brought in at the 21. A 40-yard punt, 5 yards on the return. And that will come the offense as they take over. The Green Bay offense now about ready to take possession here.
And it's hard to imagine that the first half could have gone any better for them. So what's the approach here in the second half?
Just continue to play smart football because they got the other
And nothing but green grass here, middle of the field. Touchdown, Packers. A.J. Dillon, ready for the regular season with his second touchdown of the game.
And the Packers are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead.
And that run massively increased his production in this game, and now he's over 100 yards.
And break out your calculator, partner, because his yards per carry went up significantly, right? Big-time jaunt all the way to the end zone.
Carlson on for the PAT. And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now, as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. I'm not sure if they drew that play up to score, but it scored indeed. One play on the ground and into the end zone for 6.
Daniel Carlson is set to kick off.
Following the touchdown, ready to kick it away, is Carlson. And no return here for Reed. This will be a touchback. L.A. readies for its next possession.
Well, we're still in the third quarter, so there's some time to kind of clean this up and make it look more respectable now. A win, that's probably gone out the window, Charles, but I don't know. Do you look at this as a time to just improve and maybe start to look towards the future?
I think you have to find something to play for, something to grasp onto until the clock runs out. But, Brandon, we've been around this game a long time. This is an outlier. You don't get many blowouts like this, no matter how the game looks on paper going in. This one has turned out to be everyone's worst nightmare realized.
And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down. The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. Right back to Spiller on 2nd down. And only a couple for him there as the tackle is made at the 42. These guys have punted 4 times already, and they're staring at a 5th, barring a conversion here on 3rd down. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. Offensively lucky there, able to keep the football, but now 4th down, so they'll have to boot it away.
I do think, though, they're going to look at this as a positive. 1, they recovered the fumble, so they retained possession. But 2, being able to punt it changes field position for them. Imagine if that turnover takes place there. Now your defense has to go onto the field and try and hold. Instead, they get a little breathing room.
And on 4th down, on is the punt team sending this one away. This is taken at the 18. So possession goes over here on the punt, and Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field.
Well, partner, you know, coaches always say that every play is designed to score a touchdown. Sometimes that's not really true, but last drive, that was the case. 1 play to get into the end zone, and now they'll try to duplicate that success here.
And it's rare for those moments to happen. Incredible when they do. And you saw the celebration. Pure, unbridled joy after that one.
Now a nice play defensively on 1st down as this is knocked away and incomplete. On 2nd down, Dillon. And some room to roam now. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. Touchdown, Packers. A.J. Dillon, 73 yards.
And the Packers get another third quarter touchdown to add on to that lead.
Go ahead and give him the hat trick. He's been in the end zone now 3 times.
You toss your fedora first, okay? You go ahead and do that. But let's be honest about it. That 3rd one, that's the most spectacular run he's had in the ballgame. It's almost as if he's been playing his own game of, can I top this? And each run has been more spectacular than the last.
Carlson now to add the extra point. And the lead grows even larger here in the 3rd quarter.
makes the score. Packers
so two plays on that scoring drive. That's how they drew it up. And the long run into the end zone, and what a run it was.
Daniel Carlson set to kick off.
Following the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Carlson. No run back here for Reed, so this will come out to the 25. The Chargers getting set to go.
And really, Charles, not much of a surprise that they're losing. They just haven't been able to get much of anything going in the pass game. And as you well know, in today's NFL, if the passing game isn't working, usually not much else is working either.
You're exactly right about that, partner. And I know that right now the easy answer would be, hey, let's run the football. But that might not be everything you need. So despite the fact that they've struggled throwing it, they've got to find some type of a play, multiple plays, that puts the ball in the air and allows them to have some success.
Right back to Spiller on second down. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. On first and 10 is Spiller. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
Brings up second and 11 at the 38-yard line.
One quarter remains here on a Sunday night. We'll return with more preseason football on EA Sports.
Back now at SoFi Stadium in Inglewood.
And this is a blowout so far as we get set for the fourth quarter. A very one-sided affair. Out of the gun, Blau. He rifles one that's intercepted. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And into the end zone, it's a pick six and a Packer touchdown.
Well, this one was already ugly, and now it's just kind of becoming a feast on the defensive side of the football.
Yeah, partner, this is a unit that knows they've got this game in the bag with this huge lead, and it's going to drive their coaches crazy because they're telling them, play it straight, do all the right things. But these guys are going to be freewheeling now. All of them are going to take chances, and that one pays off with an INT and a return for six.
Carlson on for the PAT. And this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead. So the defense creating some points, not only getting the interception, but then returning it to the end zone for the pick six. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And this will come out to the 25 as Reed opts for the touchback. Here's the Los Angeles offense as they get set to take possession.
And certainly this, not the performance that they were hoping for to begin the exhibition season, but still plenty to watch for in this fourth quarter.
After the pick six, they go right back to the air. And this one complete to Reed. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35.
13 yards on the play.
On first down, Blau. That's taken in by the tight end, McKinney. They'll give him 4 yards there, and that will bring up second down. He'll look to throw.
All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted.
And into the end zone, it's a pick six and a Packer touchdown.
But just add that to the list of great moments for this defense today. They've really shredded that game plan on the other side all four quarters. And, Charles, that pick six, that's kind of the cherry on top.
Yeah, and they did it, and I feel like I'm quoting a bad movie line, but they did it together, didn't they? Fed off of each other, every big play they made, every tackle, every pick, everything they've done, They continually built energy in this one, and how about them culminating with a pick six?
Carlson now to add the extra point. And this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead. A heck of a play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown. And no return here for Reed. This will be a touchback. Here comes the Chargers offense now back out onto the field.
Well, it's been a struggle so far for this offense, Charles. It's not only that they haven't been able to put the points up, but really stringing yards together has been a real issue for them in this one.
I'm so glad you brought up the yardage because I was thinking to myself, we've seen a lot of NFL
games. And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. Picked off by Quay Walker, and they're going to set up shop at the 27-yard line.
Oh, my goodness, CD. I mean, this defense just continuing to dominate. They're really dominating on both sides of the ball, but for the defense, that's now three interceptions for them here in this ballgame.
And what a great teaching tape for this defensive coordinator, right? When they go back and review this game, what does he always tell us that he preaches to his team? We're going to lead the league in effort. Well, they're doing that in this game as well as making big plays.
It's one play at a time, baby. Let's go. Let's go right here. It's showtime, baby.
Running up the middle, here's Dillon. And only a yard this time as he's taken down right around the 26.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on his faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
239 yards on the ground for him now as he has gotten better, really, as the night's going on. On third down, here's Dillon. And he'll have the first down, getting this one to the 14-yard line. Just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive.
Brandon, when a defense just simply can't get off the field on third down, and we all know how important that down is for both sides of the ball, you often feel like you're just a step behind whatever they're doing offensively.
And one of the differences in this game, no doubt, third down conversion, and that is going to be a story they'll talk about after this one. Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. They run once more with Dillon.
Got you, boy. Got you, boy.
And he was able to shed one tackle but could not get away from there. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
Now Dillon on the inside give. 9 yards on the play there, and it'll set him up first and goal.
He was brought down by J.T. Woods. First and goal, Green Bay.
Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's Packer football here as we welcome you back. They've got it first and goal in a game that appears to have already been decided. They'll run here with Dillon, and he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly.
Well, when coaches come into a game preaching total team effort, CD, I think this is the type of ball game that they're dreaming of. It was pretty apparent early on that they were clicking in all three phases. It's been fun to watch.
Yeah, sometimes in the NFL, you end up with matchups like we've been watching here. And when you go back to the early drives, You could just see that one squad was on a different level in this game. Safe to say, we have been disappointed in watching their execution throughout this contest.
Carlson on for the PAT. Now this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead. A drive that time of six plays. And it was A.J. Dillon who capped it off with a touchdown run. Following the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Carlson. No run back here for Reed, so this will come out to the 25. The Charger offense making their way back out there. At this point, partner, things looking pretty bleak. They still haven't scored here in the fourth quarter, facing the big deficit. Silver linings, what can they look to do here offensively?
You know, it's funny, I talked about this with a coach in the offseason and kind of had this scenario, like, what feels good to you and what feels good to your team? You're down big. You really have, like, one possession left, and you're trying to put points on the board that don't matter. Do that, and he told me they actually do matter. And in this situation, he's going to try and run the best offense he can run, have at least a little bit of confidence to take away from that game. So right now, they're going to try their best to get something up on the board and not get shut out.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
And that's another play that's painted the picture of this game overall. It's been a blowout. It's been continually fueled by big turnovers and stops for one side, and an inability to advance the ball from the other.
And now the third down throw incomplete as well.
At this point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can. They're still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
On is the Chargers punter now, as he's on to kick it away. And we'll see what he can do on the return. And just a net of 31 here. 40-yard punt, 9 on the return. The Packers offense now, they get ready to head back onto the field.
They lead big. Quite the kickoff, really, to this exhibition schedule as they start once more with a 1st and 10.
They'll begin the drive with a run by Dillon. And he'll power ahead, but only for about 3 yards. 2nd down coming up.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
Brings up 2nd and 7.
On 2nd down, another run for Dillon. And they'll work this down to the 40-yard line. Tackled there. It's a gain of 16 and a 1st down for the green and gold.
No doubt those are the types of carries they're looking for here, Charles. The lead in the fourth quarter. This is when coaches that have a reliable running game, they breathe a little easier on the sideline.
Yeah, they love the idea that they can take the air out of the football at this point of the game. That means they're really counting on that offensive line, counting on the runners, taking care of the football. Because you're going to tell your quarterback, hey, no time to be a hero. We're not going to throw it here. Just eat up that clock. And if you have the ball, they can't score.
Dillon up the middle. They find some open field here.
Got you, boy.
And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 and mark him at the 5. That one's good for 35 yards on the ground and a 1st down.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a 1st down, he's the guy they've turned to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it to him and keep picking up good yardage.
And they've got three tight ends here on first and goal to add some extra mass. Up the middle they run. Here's Dillon. And he'll take this for a short gain on what will prove to be the final play of this ball game.
For the winning team here, Charles, that's about as big and clean of a win as you could hope for in the National Football League. No turnovers. Meanwhile, you forced turnovers. You didn't allow any points, and you put up a bunch of points. What an effort.
And, Brandon, I just have to ask you, that's all the stuff that we saw happen today. Those are statistics, numbers, the whole deal. But my question is, how does one team come ready to play and the other one, obviously, not ready at all?
Well, I mean, I obviously don't have an answer to that, but that was the story from the get-go. One side was awake and ready, and the other just seemed asleep.
It's another one. We got another one. It's her. Who that? Big baby slot.